Okay, I haven't talked to you much about the standard form of a quadratic equation, but I'm writing it as we speak here, and this is the standard form where you put the x term first, followed by the linear x term, and then your constant. Now in this case, a, b, and c are just plain numbers. X is our variable. So in this case, a is the coefficient of the x squared term. So if I had 3x squared plus 2x plus 3 equals 0, 3 is A, 2 is B, and C is positive 3. Now the sign goes with these. Whoops, C is positive 3. Okay, so I haven't really talked too much about this, but now we come to the point where we can't do anything. We can't factor quadratic. Completing the square is too difficult, or we forgot how. A lot of different reasons, but here comes the tool in your toolbox, which I call the hammer because it's nothing but brute force, and that's called the quadratic formula. The quadratic formula will give us the roots of any quadratic. X is equal to minus b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4 times a times c all over 2a. Well, where am I getting these a, b's, and c's? Well, they come out of that standard form. So if you have something, let's say we have x squared plus 6x plus 4 equals 0. We can solve this and determine what x is by just plugging our a, b's, and c's into this quadratic formula. You should memorize this formula because you'll need it. The coefficient of the x is just positive 1, so a is equal to 1. The coefficient of the x term is positive 6, so b is equal to 6. The c here, the number all by itself, our constant term, is just positive 4, so that's equal to 4. There's where our a, b's, and c's are, right there, when you put those in order. So all we have to do is plug them into our quadratic formula. So x is equal to minus b is minus 6, plus or minus the square root of b squared, which is 36, minus 4 times a, which is 4, times c, which is 4, which is 16, all over 2 times a, which is just 2. So now simplifying this, x is equal to minus 6 plus or minus the square root of 36 minus 16 is the square root of 20, all over 2. Square root of 20 is square root of 4 times 5, so a 2 comes out. So x equals minus 6 plus or minus 2 root 5 all over 2. And now our 2 can cancel out into here. And we end up with x equal to minus 3 plus or minus the square root of 5. Okay, in this quadratic, our a is 1, so this is our a, 1, b is 6, c is 6. I'm going to put it into our quadratic formula. So t, our variable, will be equal to minus b, which is minus 6, plus or minus the square root of b squared, which is 36, minus 4 times a, which is 4, a is 1, so 4 times 1 is 4, times 6 is 24, all over 2 times a, and a is 1, so this is just 2. Okay, we can simplify this by subtracting the 24 from the 36 now in here, okay, and we get 12, right? So we have minus 6 plus or minus, and 12 is 4 times 3, so we have 2 root 3 all over 2, and now our 2 can cancel out into here, and we end up with t equal to minus 3 plus or minus the square root of 3. Now there are two roots here. As I told you, in a quadratic, when you have a quadratic, you will have two answers. As before, when you factored and you used the zero product rule, you have two answers here. One of them is negative 3 plus root 3, and the other one is negative 3 minus root 3. But we just usually put them together as plus or minus 3. Now, when you have a quadratic and it's not all on the left side or not on the same side of the equation, you have to get it all on the same side of the equation. Because just like when you were factoring and using the zero product rule, you have to get everything over and set it all equal to zero. So that means 5r squared plus 12r, because when it comes over here it becomes positive, plus 8 equals zero. So just get everything on the left side and put them in order. The squared term, the linear term, and the constant term. Okay, now you apply the quadratic formula. This is A, this is B, and this is C. So I have R equal to minus 12, which is minus B, plus or minus the square root of B squared, which is 144, minus 4 times A is 20, times C, so it's 20 times 8, it's 160, all over 2 times A, and A is 5, so that's 10 down here. So now R is equal to minus 12 plus or minus the square root of 144 minus 160 gives us a negative number, but we know how to deal with negative square roots now. So negative 16 over 10. So this becomes, remember, negative 16 is just 4i plus or minus 4i. So we're going to get minus 12 plus or minus 4i all over 10. And now we can divide out a 2, which gives our denominator 5, 2i, and 6. So we have minus 6 plus or minus 2 all over 5 for r. 2i, I left off the 2i. In this case, you might decide to subtract your 8x from both sides, and that would be fine, and you'll get the same answer I do when you put them in order. But I prefer to work with my a as positive, so I'm going to put the x squared over here and give it an x squared positive plus 8x minus 1 equals 0, because I put the 1 over there. So now my a is 1, b is 8, c is negative 1. So we have x equal to minus b, minus 8, plus or minus the square root of b squared, minus 4 times a, which is 4, times c, which is negative 4. So I'm subtracting a negative 4, which means I'm adding a positive 4, all over 2a, which is 2. So I get minus 8 plus or minus the square root of 68 all over 2. Now reduce this. I'm not going to take the time to reduce this, but reduce this. Get a factor out here that's divisible by 2, and then you can cancel out.